Okay, next is the installation of a roller blind. Now, these roller blinds killed two babies within 2 weeks just in the area I live. I'll say that again. This type of roller blind has killed two babies within 2 weeks just in the area I live. If you don't believe me, just Google Hornsby baby deaths around about the first or second month of 2014. Hornsby, New South Wales. There should be something on it. I read the warning. Curtain and blind cords. That there is a curtain or blind cord. Have caused the death of young children and must be installed so they are not a strangulation hazard. Follow the installation instructions. What you'll have is a scenario where baby's in a cot, the cot's here, the cord's here, it's not hung up out of the way, it's down like this. The baby plays with this, it gets wrapped around his neck, and a baby's top heavy, his head's heavy, his body's light, and he'll twist around like that, and he's dead. He gets strangulated. You know, he might grab it and try and pull himself up out of the cot or up off the ground, and he might put his head through to try and get higher, and off he goes, and he's dead. So you put them up on a hook. This hook should be supplied by the manufacturer. Right up off the ground. I'll put them up twice, so that's up off the ground. The manufacturer supplies a hook, or a thing to keep it in place, but it's down here, and it's still down low where a child can reach it. This is a warning and a video that anybody anywhere can use. I give anyone permission to use this, just get the word out there. Because I don't like driving home after work and hearing that someone's lost a little baby girl after work. Okay, so this is how I install these blinds. I install the ends, which are these two pieces. The one with the notches in is the one, or the side for the cord. So I just install them 10mm back from that edge there. So around about there. The reason for this is that I've got this edge here, and that's what you pull on to open the window. And it comes about 20mm out. So if you have it right in the middle, the cords or the blind's probably not going to clear this point here. Thank you. Okay, so I've got my two sides, I've got the two holders, and what I'm going to do now is just measure the distance from there across to the other side. Okay, so I've measured from the end to the other end, which is falls about here, and now that's just being trimmed. I'm going to trim about, say, 50 or 60 mil off the edge. Okay, so it's trim time, and it's sitting on plastic to keep the face of the blind covered. And there's my marks there that I'll trim. Keep your hands clean, wash your hands. Okay, so now the caps are on either side. This bit here has been trimmed off and the edge has been trimmed of the material, and I use this thin blade cutting wheel. So this is the way these blinds work. The rotating mechanism sits on this side here, and on the other side, the side I cut, there's just a round nib, and that sits along here, and it is pushed down and it clicks into that hole there. Now there's this weight that sits on the bottom of the blind, and I'll just mark that and cut it and install it. Okay, so this next step's going to be probably the most important part of the installation, and it could very well save a baby's or a young child's life. Just get a hook like this. I've measured 250 mm down from the top, and I've got my pencil mark there, and I'm going to stick this there. Okay, so the hook's installed. And what you do every single day, whether the blind's up or down, you get this cord and you put it over the hook, and it still hangs down. You get it again and put it over the hook. If you don't do that, the chances are that while you're living in the house, the next people, a child on one window somewhere in the house can get tangled up and strangled. Leave the warning tag on, and it tells you to do that in the instructions. Tell all your friends and put the word around that particular cord is very dangerous. That is to say that all pull-down blind cords are very dangerous.